All right, guys, welcome back. Going to the second half here of Dropped Frame. Still don't know what week it is. What fucking... I'm going to look up the week. Fuck it.
28.
Is it 28? Nope, 29th. 29th. How are you guys off?
Both? Okay.
Why did you both say 28th? Were you copying him?
We were talking with Pluto before the show, and he asked how many weeks we'd done it, and it was 28. So, and then both me and Zeke didn't realize
that. Well, I guess
this is the next week.
I guess technically you guys have been on 26 because we've done two of the all girl shows or whatever.
And so. I think we each missed one too that got
so yeah. Like, so, but you guys it was probably like 25th if we're getting technical.
And well, and speaking of the all girls show, the Drop Femmes, like when I went to look up hashtag Drop Frames. Drop Femmes comes up first.
Yeah. Well, the show had like 30,000 people.
Are you really surprised they're more popular than us, Zeke? Yeah. Is that surprising?
The show is like super popular.
Yeah, dude. No, it's awesome. I was just like, come on, we've been doing this. Oh, it was just a little twinge, but I'm happy for that.
Yeah, you don't have to be so fucking jealous, Jesus.
I can't. That's what drives me.
So sexist. How do we deal with people like this in this world anymore?
Shut up!
Fucking Christ.
Paint me
Before we
not.
Get into whatever the fuck we're going to talk about, one of the things we're going to be doing in the future, I don't know when. I don't know if this will happen before PAX. Probably in between PAX and TwitchCon. Ko's been working on some stuff. Are we just calling it the Drop Frames How to Stream? You just want to call it that? We'll think of
how to get started on Twitch.
Okay,
yeah,
there
pretty
you go.
Much.
We'll think of a wittier thing than that. But we're gonna do some shows that are just about that. And they'll be super instructional, super hopefully informational. That's the goal, at least. And I think it'll probably be there's a lot of information to cover. So I think it'll probably be like two, possibly three shows that'll break into all of that.
And we'll go through like your rig, your streaming equipment, your camera, your like OBS or the other one that I hate.
XSplit?
Yeah.
The idea is when we're done with it, if anyone ever asks you a question about, hey, I want to start streaming on Twitch, where do I go? We go these episodes. Everything you're going to need to know to get started is covered somewhere in these episodes. And if you watch them, it's like a big FAQ on how to get started on streaming. That's
kind of the goal.
Basically, I think what a lot of us wanted when we started that just wasn't, it just didn't exist.
Well, yeah, it's like, hey, let's do a podcast and we'll talk about how to stream. And okay, well, I'll turn on the stream and then we don't have an outline. Fuck, I guess we'll just interview people for the next couple of weeks.
No, there is an episode that of Drop Frames that I point to.
Yeah,
whenever anybody like emails me now, I'm like, I could give you my usual spiel, but I think the best thing to do is just to watch this hour and a half of Drop Frames, because we covered a lot of like important shit in that. But I think a focus on that technical aspects and that kind of shit, I think that would be, it's important. And I think I'm really happy that we're going to be able to do that.
Yeah. And right now, Ko's kind of spearheading that outline just because I've been fucking dealing with other shit, and he took the initiative, so appreciate it.
Like a kidney
that.
Stone, dude?
Absolutely.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
It's all good.
Valid excuse.
I'm hopped up on painkillers, but we're good. Anyways.
Now, is it? Did you pass it? Is it done?
They said it was, and this is the frightening thing, they said it was like one of the smallest ones that they had seen in a very long time, and it was still... on no question, the worst pain I have ever experienced before.
For one of us, hopefully forever uninformed about this, what exactly is small in kidney stone
like
you're talking like grain of sand?
Yeah, well, no, like that, like very, very small. You can't even see like the center of my finger right there. It's very, very small. Like I don't know,
like don't a BB.
Yeah, like almost like a BB, maybe even smaller than a BB gun or like a BB.
Wow.
They get up to golf ball size, and those just prompt surgery. You just have to go to surgery for those.
Yeah, there ain't no getting that out.
We were talking about this last night on roleplay. My brother spent 3 days in the hospital with his, and they actually had him sit in like this giant vat of water, and then they blast him with sonic waves on the side to try to like break it up in his kidney. And that's like one of the more recent advancements they've had in this.
I've actually heard about that.
So wait, the thinking there is that instead of having it surgically removed as one hole, that you get to pass a whole lot of little ones?
Yeah, but a lot of the times, like they told me that I wouldn't really know that I've passed it. I could only feel it like going through my kidney. But like when I actually pass it, I wouldn't know because it would by then be most of the, because of the meds I'm taking, everything will just be so diluted that I won't even know.
Yeah, that's my.
But that's like, not what happened, right?
What with me?
Is that what happened? Yeah, like.
Oh,
like,
I don't know. Like I still have pains in my kidney, but it might just be from soreness because it swells around the actual stone when it's in your kidney.
So that's what
can last.
That's when it hurts is when it's in your kidney, not when you're passing.
Oh yeah, that's think of like, and it was funny too because I walked into the ER yesterday and they kept like asking me all these questions and shit, and I'm just like. I literally stopped. I was like, guys, I will tell you all the secrets about me. Just give me some fucking morphine or put some painkillers in my body because I cannot. Like, they asked me to fill out all these forms, and I'm just, like, pacing around in, like, the worst pain of my life. And they're just like, so when were you born? And I'm just like, look, I'm so sorry, but can you just get me on the fucking IV? Like, I beg that. You. I fucking beg you.
Like, Glenn Gary, Glenn Ross, like, fuck you, that's my name.
It was pretty bad. It was a rough pain. Waking up, it was like I got shot in the kidney, and then that pain was like a dull and flat pain. It wasn't sharp, but that just gets worse over time until it just gets to the point of like, they gave me anti-nausea into my IV because the pain, they told me the pain was going to be so bad that eventually I would start feeling like I had to throw up. I was like, that's just stupid. Sure enough, like in the middle of the show last night, I threw up because of how much pain I was in. And so I never want to experience anything like that again. Luckily, the pain has subsided from that. But it was rough. I envy anyone that has kidney stones. And apparently they can be like a reoccurring problem. So it was fucking intense. It was intense.
So I'm sure glad I kept this around.
Yeah, yeah.
Sally gotta get the juice, put it in a candy feel a little better.
I wish I had some of that. No, they gave me like, I think I'm on, what is this? I think it's just straight up codeine. Yeah, it's just codeine, which is pretty strong. But
yeah.
I've been popping like three of those every couple hours. Anyways, enough about my...
Did they tell you what caused that?
No, it can. There's so many different things that can cause it, like diet. Apparently, if you drink a lot of tap water and it's like bad unfiltered tap water, it can fuck with your kidneys. And so, like to get a filter on faucets is something we have one. I drink bottled water most of the time. They said like stress can attribute. There's so many different factors that there's not one single identifiable factor with all this.
Eggs. Too many eggs.
They said that actually a lot, like high amounts of salt can actually form them quickly than other things. So probably.
Oh! You know what you should do?
What's that?
You should treat it like a pearl from an oyster and like put it in a ring.
Yeah. There you go, dude. If you want to see some terrifying stuff, Google kidney stones and go to images.
Nope.
And then just look at some of the stones that have come out of people. It is
no.
Oh good, my man. God, what I'm is good. That? What is that game that kids play that has the little like six sided spike thing? You know what I'm talking
Jax?
About? Yeah. It looks like that, but with like 30 other points on it. It's fucking horrifying, dude.
That's awesome.
That's.
Oh no!
I googled
no.
that yesterday. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna go to the ER. I'm just gonna fucking drive there. So.
You think it's a little karma for, you know, laughing at my particular pain that, you know, when I was having my throat surgery?
No, not really.
Nah. Couldn't be.
I don't think there was any karma involved. It was just whatever. Anyways, let's talk about what's been going on this week. I guess we could just start off with, I think, me and Co. I don't know if Zeke has, because you're still doing Bashi, right? Where are you at a Bashi?
Yeah, well, here's the thing. I've come to terms with Bashi in that I know I'm going to be playing it every day, but what I normally do is play it for about 6 hours, and then I cool down or wind down with something more fun. Like I'm trying to keep my promise while keeping my sanity.
Yeah.
And so I'll play it like, and I'm making like I'm on the last boss, the final boss. I'm on Solgrin in Bashi, but I know like I remember watching Man vs. Game, and I remember watching like lots of other people play, and I know how long Solgrin's going to take. But the encouraging thing is every day I'm making like. And I know it sounds weird, but in a video game, but like I'm making like 1 to 2 seconds of progress, like every day on the boss. Like I'm making it 1 to 2 seconds further,
right,
towards killing the boss, and I'm
this
getting
is
my
boss
muscle.
For those that have never seen it before,
yeah, it's liquid insanity. This boss fight all the way through.
This is phase one, right? Is this phase three?
Four phases. This is phase one. Okay. Yes, this is phase one. Yeah. And if you see the shit that's going on the screen, you just have to get it ingrained in your memory. And well, this part in particular, when he's like flashing and like warping and shit, that's all random. So if there is one thing in Bocchi that is the worst thing I would say, and I know this is actually saying a lot, it's that box teleporting on top of you and telefragging you, and there's no escape. There's no dodge to that.
Right.
I will argue that until I'm blue in the fucking face that if he, because like at the end, in the credits, it says all the attacks are dodge, or even in the song, I think it says all the attacks are dodgeable. It's like there's one attack, one thing in the game that is not dodgeable, and that is when that fucking box of oatmeal appears on top of you, there's no way to get out of that. You're dead. You're just fucked. It's like if someone dropped a dinosaur on your head out of nowhere.
Yeah. Makes sense.
But yeah, I'm making this couple seconds of progress. But I am playing different games, like to wind down, like 2 or 3 hours after I'm done with Bocchi for the day. Like I play Rocket League or Hearthstone. But yesterday I got a chance to try out the 4-player co-op of Adventures. Oh shit.
Wanderlust Adventures.
Thank you, Wanderlust
Adventures. I was actually going to ask you about that, so it's perfect.
Yeah, and I got and it was.
Is that what this is?
Yep, okay. and it was awesome that Leth, one of the main creators of the game, was in the TeamSpeak, and we got to talk to him about the game itself and play it with. One of our players dropped out, and we actually got to play the game with him, which was very, very cool.
What the fuck am I look like? What is this? What is this game?
It's 4-player co-op, procedurally generated. Dungeons and enemies, but except for the quests and stuff, you get like there's normally you get quests, you go out and do them. Like, we're in a dungeon right now. We met the Zelda guy at the bottom of the thing. They did a little nod to Zelda because he says, it's dangerous to go alone, take this. And then I think someone says, like, a wooden sword, are you kidding me, or whatever. But yeah, you go through dungeons, and like there's 4-player co-op, it's online co-op. I don't know I'm pretty sure there's probably local co-op, but don't quote me on that, I don't really know.
Yeah.
But everybody has a different class. Like I was the mage. There's like rogues and warriors and that kind of stuff. Just like a regular old any other role playing game. And you pick up items, you upgrade, you get companions. Companions are an important part of the game because you go out and find like it's like you get recipes for like companions. You get recipes for armor. You get recipes for like jewelry to craft stuff. To wear and that kind of stuff, and you can get like, I have a dire wolf. Like I found a contract for a dire wolf, and you take it back to town. It's like, oh, you can have a dire wolf companion now, and you can level them up as you go along and that kind of stuff.
Oh wow!
This is the arena where you can make a lot of cash, and you just keep fighting until you die.
Interesting.
It's a really fun game, to be honest.
Is this on Steam?
Yep, it's on Steam. It's actually funny story. It got released one day early on accident. Ooh. Talking to Leth, he was like, this is how he described it. He said, there was a big green button, and I accidentally pushed it. And it was like, it released a day early, and he was like, everybody on the team was like, oh, fuck, oh, shit, oh, no. But they handled it pretty well because there's still a couple of bugs and stuff. Like wireless controllers have trouble working with the game. But, like I said, there's just some shit to work out, but that's, any game these days. But yeah, release it daily, but it's available on Steam now, $14.99, if you want to pick it up. But it's a blast, and I highly recommend playing it with friends.
The Mr. Shart Evans, is that your name?
That's my pet's name. Because one of my mods is the Mr. Scott Evans. So I named my direwolf the Mr. Shart Evans.
I like how your mage kind of looks like you. If this.
That's exactly what I did. I made him like red and black, like my colors, and... he kind of looks like me.
You guys have the new Twitch player, right? Do you have this on yours or no?
I don't think so. I don't think I've done it yet.
Oh, so you don't have
that HTML injection thing? Little.
Yeah, like the there's no gray bar at the bottom anymore. So it's like a translucent thing.
Oh no! Oh. Is that I heard about like people were talking about it, but is that something I have to do? Is that something I have to do myself?
No, like it just showed up for me. It just started working. I think they're just rolling out very slow. I don't think it's HTML5. I think this is still Flash, like the actual video player. But it is a different skin to it, I guess is the appropriate term for it, which I think is what they're going to be using in the future. So it's not bad. It's cool, I guess. I it looks like YouTube, to be honest. Like, it just straight up looks like the new YouTube player to me. But I was curious if you guys had messed around with it.
What are the improvements?
I mean, it's all, from what I can gather, it's all visual improvements. Like, the actual UI, there's no video player improvements to it, I don't think. It just looks nicer. It doesn't look like the old one where you have the gray. Like, I can still go into my dashboard, and if I go to my dashboard, I still have, like, that gray bar at the bottom that'll come up with the volume slider and all that stuff. This is all just, like, translucent here at the bottom. I'm doing a poor job of showing it, but you can see, like, the timeline and stuff there. It's pretty cool. I don't know. I wish they would. Nice. They need to go to HTML5 as fast as possible, but they're probably going to save that for TwitchCon.
Talking about the bar at the bottom that has, like, the volume control and that kind
of
stuff, right?
That's what this is, yeah. Like, is that not show? I don't know how to, like, show this better.
I'm seeing it on yours, but.
Yeah, like, see right here.
Yeah, I'm seeing it on yours, but I'm not, like, maybe I have to go to a video because it's not on my dashboard or anything.
Yeah, the dashboards don't have it. It's only, like, on any other normal stream or, like, a broadcast or something like that, so.
Also, if I just go, instead of slash dashboard, I just go to my channel.
Yeah, that's where you would see it.
Okay. Continue talking. I'm going to be looking.
Mine's not updated.
Okay. Yeah, I don't. I guess I was just lucky for them to get it. Did you get it? You have it, Z?
Yeah. That's the thing. It's not on my. It's not on the channel I'm hosting, which is Drop Frames. But I think it is on my.
It would be site wide for you at that point.
Oh, that's just okay. Never mind then.
But yeah, that's cool.
I don't have it yet.
I think they're just, you know, slowly rolling that stuff out. So
okay.
Anything else that you've been playing, Z? Anything?
Let's see. Anything else I've been playing?
You played a little. Did you play the new Rocket League patch yesterday or no?
Oh, I played it last night actually. I was offline.
Yeah.
I hit my brother up and we played some 4v4 last night.
This is not the new patch, but there's just some Rocket League footage. But yeah.
Yeah. No, it's cool. I like that. Like, one of my favorite things is the boom. That comes when you explode somebody, it just says it like in smoke after you blow somebody up. It says boom in big capital letters in smoke.
That's nice.
I don't know what else. That was like the one thing I noticed.
They put in ranked 3v3 instead of like the solo ranked. You can now queue with three people.
Oh, ranked. I don't do ranked. It's just a waste of time for me.
Wait, what did they do, JP?
So it's like ranked 3v3 instead of solo queue. You can queue up with a team of three, and it throws you against other teams of three. With like ranked, kind of like how they had ranked 2v2, but ranked 3v3. And then I think
I also like how they put the fucking downloadable content on the front page, and you can't have it yet. That's
well, I saw someone.
That's always a dick move to do that. It's like, hey, downloadable content. Nope, can't select it. Fuck you.
I thought there was footage of like the new map already out there. Maybe it's just footage. Maybe it's not actually out there.
No, on the menu screen it says downloadable content, right at the top.
I didn't know that.
Select it yet.
I didn't know that. I know our, I guess you could call him our friend, Gasky Mexican, got his community flag.
Oh, and that's the other thing. Yeah, I saw Gassy's flag and Lyric's flag.
Yeah. They, the line that I got was time constraints is the reason the mine's not in there. And I wanted to just be like, guys, come on now. The real answer is that you're not important enough to be in our game. That's all it is. It's all you have to say. You don't have to say time.
We would be okay if you never streamed our game again.
That's why I was just like, come on, guys. It's a fucking PNG that you put onto a flag and the flag does a little waviness.
Yeah.
Time constraints.
You know the best part. You know the best part. They're going to make you wait 3 weeks and they're going to put your flag in.
They said shit emoticon
on a flag.
They said the next patch 1.5 or 1.6 is when they would be in there. So, anyways,
nice.
But yeah,
nice.
I thought that was hilarious.
Which
is it going to be? Your flag like they're showing in the chat right now, the ITME Nation.
No, it's just going to be like the little itmeJP logo that Christian did a while back. I thought about like having a special one made, and I was like, I don't fucking care. I'm not going to have something crazy made. So we'll just use that. It's the same one that they're using on the, this is called a segue. It's the same one they're using on my H1Z1 shirt, which I think Co has. And I think Zeke, you have one as well, right?
Nope.
You don't have one?
Nope. They invited me to the thing. They asked me for headshot and stuff. And I said, hey, I saw some saw some shirts. I didn't see, like, I don't know, like, he didn't ask me or whatever, but, you know, I sent him a graph. They're like, we're not actually doing any more shirts right now, but then I was like, okay.
That sucks.
it's all right.
I didn't know they only asked, like, certain people. I guess they did, though. I don't know who, do you guys know who Curvy Llama is?
A little recall humor. I wasn't big enough.
I mean, they have some very small streamers in here for sure.
Wasn't big enough to get my own shirt. You weren't big enough to get your own flag.
Yeah.
No, I think the H1Z1 guys specifically picked people that have either streamed a lot of it in the past or stream it still currently.
Yeah.
Oh. So okay. There's a lot of streamers that got shirts that are smaller streamers, but they're kind of big in the H1Z1 community.
Oh, dude, no, it doesn't. I'm not butthurt, and it didn't surprise me. I was just talking shit just because I thought it was funny.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, I'm going to be a part of that.
I'm pretty fucking excited for this today. Event. I'm really stoked for this event. When they asked me to do this 2 months ago, I was so in. I hadn't played the game in a long time, so I went back to it last Friday. And I've put in probably 40 hours since then of playing the game. Because they put in, so now, I don't know if you knew this, but you can queue with 2 people or 5 people in Battle Royale, like as a team. And it makes the game so much more fun. Because now that stress that was all on one person is split between 2 people or 5 people. And it's kind of just like, there's not really any other game like it. It's Battle Royale with teams that are actual teams. That just has like a full-on matchmaking, but a full-on queue system, which is super fucking fun. I would highly suggest you checking it out, Zeke. It's some of the most fun I've had in that game in a very, very long time.
And it's 5v5?
It's 5 versus the other 100 players.
Or 2v2.
Yeah, so or 2v2. You basically
can go in with 2 or go in with 5.
Gotcha, okay.
Yeah.
Or you can be a man like me and go in the 5-man solo.
See, you can do that, it'll match you up with 4 other people.
That'd be awesome. Oh. I wish I could.
No, you can do that.
You call it Iron Man mode. Oh, you can?
You can. It'll match you up with 4 other people in game. The thing is that it's 4 other people in game. So really what that equates to is like, hey, I know where that person is. Let's just go kill them. Then people just start killing their teammates. It adds an interesting perspective to it. But it's a lot of fun. They're
like the partners idea, the duos idea. That's really
it's
cool.
It's so good,
like,
dude.
Two people kind of crawl. I haven't done any of the team stuff yet.
You should really, like, you and Zeke should hop into the 2v2 BR thing. It's or the 2v all, whatever. Duo queue, I guess, is the best way to describe it. It's great.
This is like the first time that I can honestly say, like, Name a big streamer and they're gonna be in this.
Yeah, dude. Like, let's just go down the list: Lyric, Summit, Soda Pop, and Gold Glove, Trick, Jericho, Giant Waffle, Legendary Leah, Tally, Dan's Gaming, Co, Reynod, Elohim, Cobalt Streak, Serious Gaming. I think that's gonna be Alan.
Oh shit! My picture's up. I just sent him the headshot yesterday.
Zeke's picture's up. Pocket, CDN, Cream, Rhino, Sexy Hexy, OP, who we were talking about earlier, Loco, Partially Royal, Das Medi. That's Lyric's brother, Grimy Bear, who I think was a
you keep feature. Saying Grimy Bear. Is it Grimy? Grimy Bear.
It's Grimy?
There's 2 M's, isn't there?
Yeah, it is 2 M's.
It's Grimy?
Okay. It's Grimy Bear, yeah.
I thought it was Grimy.
I'm pretty sure it's Grimy Bear with 2 M's, right?
I don't know. Okay. Anyways, Grims, Curvy Llama, Rakana, Bustin' the Nut. I don't even know who Bustin' the Nuts is, but that's awesome that his Twitch name is Bustin' the Nuts.
He doesn't look like a guy who would do that, though.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't.
He's like he looks like he belongs like on like Growing Pains in like the late 80s.
Dude,
like he would be like a friend of Mike Stevers.
All I heard was the name, and I hadn't seen that before, and I was like, oh, you're like, really? And I scrolled down, and it's just some guy with a nice smile. It's like, what?
Yeah.
See, now I gotta now I gotta go see.
Oh god, I don't even know if I want to try to pronounce this. Vi par la foi?
Is it French? Vi par la foi?
That sounds so much better than mine.
Maybe?
I don't know. Hold on, spell it.
V-I-E-P-A-R-L-A. F-O-I.
Yeah, foie, I think. Right. And then it's V, I think you pronounce the first part V. V par la foie.
Sure.
Awesome. I'm guessing, but I...
Yeah. They've got crates in-game where you can get a bunch of stuff. I want to get this fucking AK skin. That looks fucking sick. I don't know why they have a nice skin. I want the AK skin, though. That looks really good. Then they've got, like, the Twitch hoodie as well, which would be cool. Then they've got like all this other stuff, as well as all of our shirts. Well, most of the people's shirts.
Ha!
All the important people.
What is what? How the pro gamer hoodie skin? What? Why is that a pro gamer hoodie skin? Ark, what the fuck does this have to do with pro gaming? What is that?
Wait, what?
There's a pro gamer hoodie skin in game that looks like some vector purple and blue stuff.
Yeah, it's like wings. It's like a like mech wings or something.
I don't know. I don't know. I do want to get my shirt.
That make me a better gamer.
Do you have your shirt yet in game, Co? Have you gotten it yet?
I don't know if it's a game. They did the shirt patch just last night.
Yeah. Oh, I guess the servers have been up and down this morning, so I don't think they've been up yet. I want to play tonight, but I don't know if the servers are going to cooperate.
Dude, I played H1Z1 for the first time in a while last night, and I got on. My power went out. I turned my stream on, and my power immediately went out. And it was out for like 45 minutes, and I only had time to play like 2 hours. And so it comes up, and I'm like, I guess I'll throw it on, and we'll play for a little bit. Yeah, 3.5 hours later, dude, you lose time in that game.
I forgot about that.
Every time I play the game, there's something new or improved or fixed or added. Like, dude, I hadn't really played with the two extraneous slots yet. The Magnum, hadn't done any of that. The AK, I played with an AK for the first time last night.
Spray
the
weather looks
awesome. Baby. Yeah, dude, I did a rainy map, and it was just raining the
whole time.
It looks
less awesome on stream, but it looks great in game. Just because
it completely changed the battle royale, having like that consistent fog where you couldn't see really far ahead of you, and it was raining the whole time, and it kind of added this whole different thing to it.
Yeah,
it's really making strides every time, and I love seeing new slots in the inventory every time I go into, pretty much.
Yeah.
So. Well, still one of my favorite moments of the last year was the fist fight me and you had in H1Z1 with the car, the headlights pointing at me, and you just like duking it out in the middle.
That was some Double Dragon shit, man. That was awesome.
Yep. You whooped my ass. But yeah, I just imagine like them, like, because we stood there waiting, like, okay, your health's all the way up. All right. I just imagine them standing there, like, heaving and, like, rain falling down and, like, ready. And it's like, you get this, like, dramatic action sequence.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
It's good. It's good fun. I'm glad that I'm back in. And I'm super stoked for that tournament. I really cannot wait for that event. I assume it's going to be single person BR. Did they send out rules? And I just didn't read them.
Dude, you know, I've learned a very important lesson with BR. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go right to the H1Z1 guys, and I'm going to say, what is your exact ruling on people outside of game teaming up in this tournament?
Yeah.
Can they do it? Yes. In which case, teaming is totally cool. Or are you going to aggressively be not letting people team up?
Right.
Yes or no? And then whichever answer I find out, I'm just going to be like, okay, everyone. Like, in-game. Screw this gray BS where people are pissed that people are teaming or don't know if they're doing. We're gonna get it out early this time.
Yeah. In-game chat, in-game voice, that kind of shit.
Yeah.
Every time one of these tournaments happens, it gets one step closer to just being a really fun tournament. And, you know, there's all these little problems that have them, but we can get them out of the way early.
So, it's going to be cool.
I can't wait for it. I think it's going to be absolutely.
It's going to be really cool to have everyone there in person playing the event. Like that's what I'm most excited for. Like being able to kill someone, stand up and be like, get fucked, and then just stand back
down. Yeah, no, I was wondering that. Like, I because this is me we're talking about here.
Sure.
And yeah, I'm of the school, if you ain't cheating, you ain't trying. And I'm wondering, like, if I could get up in the middle of the BR and go up and, like, I don't know, unplug somebody's keyboard mouse. Or, like, you know, cover their eyes.
I don't think you're going to be allowed to do
sitting
that.
Right there. No, I know.
You
know, I'm just
physically mess with your opponent. You know, punch him in the back of the head, knock him out.
Listen, don't take it too far, all right? I'm joking, mostly.
Mostly. Mostly. I just hope
you're on my team, guys.
It's honestly the type
of
event.
Dirty tricks galore.
It's honestly the type of event where I think I'll be like incredibly nervous going into it because I care that much about winning this shit. More so than any other tournament.
I just want to do well. I just don't want to. Yeah. I just don't want to run around aimlessly for 3 minutes and then get shot in the back of the head.
You know that's going to happen to someone too, right? You know that's going to happen.
Oh yeah,
like,
of course.
People are going
to
land.
It's going to happen to a few people probably.
Yeah, people are going to land in like Death Valley or some shit, and there's just going to be a big fucking gunfight at the very beginning. And all those people are going to be out except for one person.
Yep.
So I can't wait. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's one of the things that got announced at TwitchCon where this is going to be happening. Find more, I think, at h1z1.com/invitational. There's money up for grabs, which I don't think anyone really cares about from the streamer world. If whoever wins, I hope they donate it. I'll be screaming at them to donate it to some charity.
Or do something interesting with it.
Yeah.
That's the big thing. Do something interesting with it.
Yeah.
But of course, unless you're a smaller streamer and you need a new computer.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But yeah, super fun.
There's a line where you're like, okay, donate it, or hey, I'm fucking keeping it.
right. But yeah, if you guys aren't playing it, feel free to check out H1Z1. It's actually kind of had a resurgence on Twitch since last week. Summit's been playing a lot. I've been playing a lot. Lyric jumped into it on Monday, I guess, is when that was.
I didn't actually look at the rules. Is it going to be teams?
I don't think so. Nope. I think it's just solo
it's
BR.
It's supposed to be standard BR. Yep.
Which, if you've played BR before, you know, like, when you get to the top 15, even the top 20, it is fucking nerve-wracking. So putting that into, like, a tournament mode, or, like, at a tournament, so to speak, I'm going to have like, four hoodies on so I don't get fucking freezing.
Dude, JP, I forgot about it. Last night I was playing, and by the way, the invisible bug sucks.
I haven't had that happen to me yet.
I left Rust for that bug, and it followed me to goddamn H1Z1. So I really hope they fix that soon. In fact, I've heard rumors the patch last night fixed it. But, man, I got to say, like, last night I got Invisi-killed after, like, 2 minutes, and then I had another game where I was, like, 9 med kits, you know, AR, everything's good, Invisi-killed again. And then the third game, I got to the top 3. And I had forgotten, as you start getting closer and closer, dude, I seriously was turn the music off, you know, leaning in like this, doing one of these on my webcam.
Yep.
People wondering what I'm doing. You know, like, oh, man.
There's
very
quick,
few
man.
Games that do that, man. Very few games.
Super intense, super quick. It's
speaking
a lot
of fun. Joe, do you guys know the Arc BR comes out tomorrow?
Strippin was telling me about that. I think Strippin's doing a server or something. I'll let him talk about that because I don't know the details
it's got
of it.
RP server, yeah. I didn't know that was for
I think
BR,
it was
though.
For BR.
That's pretty cool.
Maybe it's not. I have no idea. But yeah, I knew that, or I guess now I know that comes out tomorrow. Are you gonna jump into that?
I really want to try it. I want to look at what the changes are from the tournaments now, because I got to admit, I loved it, but I don't think I could casually do 3.5 to 5 hour games.
That's kind of my he asked me about it.
I'm wondering what they changed.
I'm like, I really don't want to fucking build, and I just want to shoot people, and that's all I do in H1Z1 is just shoot people. So why the fuck would I go play Ark? Like, that's my mindset on it. I'm not a fan of building and taming dinosaurs.
I kind of feel like they maybe they should have different types. Well, and people are telling me it's not battle royale, it's survival of the fittest. But I mean, know what BR
That's
means
exactly BR, what I was so. Going to ask. I was like, is that a copywritten thing? Or like, because people will associate that with Player Unknown if it's not, you know.
I
whatever.
Think, well, I don't know.
This
the
it's kind of like,
but.
It's kind of like the whole, you know, LOL or MOBA. You know, it's like they're all MOBAs, but at the same time, you know, we need a word like MOBA to LOL for whatever to. ER to survival of the fittest. I don't know what you'd call them, multiplayer survival strategy game based on battle royale, whatever. But anyway, but yeah, with survival of the fittest,
that'd be a shitty acronym.
I know, right? it'd be like 9 letters long. SSBLTLP14. But anyway, is there any news anywhere on what they've changed before tomorrow? Like, has there been any press release since then? Or
I guess I can look real quick. But survival art.
Oh. Wait a minute. Hold on. Someone said it is Player Unknown. He made that. He made the BR for Ark.
No. Player Unknown made the battle royale for H1Z1.
Yeah.
No. I know that.
Not for Ark. No. Player Unknown is not associated with it. With
oh, I was just looking at chat.
In team for Ark.
Yeah. I think because battle royale's copyright is a movie. I don't think anyone else holds. I think it when it's introduced as like H1Z1 BR or Arma BR, it's Player Unknown's Battle Royale. At least that's how it was in the press release that H1Z1 used. So I think that's like the legal aspect of it for those that care about that.
Okay.
I have no idea. If you actually search Survival of the Fittest, it's like the Twitch blog. I don't see any notes for it right now. I would assume those are going to come out tomorrow.
So this is pretty cool. People are saying that a lot of these settings are going to be configurable by the server provider. So I wonder if we're going to see like all these different types of SOTF servers pop up with all their different rules, which will be cool. Don't get me wrong. People will find the ones they like and, you know, do that kind of stuff. That's cool. But I got to admit, like for me, I'd want to see that circle be at its smallest radius in 2 hours max. Like
even
they,
2 hours is kind of rough, man.
Up to compensate. But yeah, even 2 hours is kind of long. Maybe an hour, you know?
I think the normal H1Z1 game, which to me is the perfect size, if you make it all the way in, I think it's like, I actually don't know because time is a completely different thing to me when I'm playing that game. I've never actually timed it. I want to say it's like 45 minutes to an hour for like a 1 BR. And I think that's the perfect size. That's a hard sell for people to sit down for 2 to 5 hours and something like Ark. But I guess
it's kind of interesting though. I will say for there is a certain attraction to having a game mode that would be 4 or 5 hours. You know, if you had an afternoon and you really wanted to, and maybe have like significantly larger rewards. Well,
yeah.
Actually, I don't think Ark has any kind of in-game reward system like H1Z1. But it could be cool to play with that. Sure. The longer ones that is. But
I was just gonna say that. Oh, sorry. I was just gonna say that, Bilford. Like that, I think LMS is a perfectly good acronym. Like
last man.
All right, acronym. Acronyms are things you actually say, right? Abbreviation. LMS. Oh, last man standing. I think LMS is fine. I know there's the gender thing, but like, come on. I mean, last man standing.
Fine. Last man standing is fine.
I think LMS. Like it's an LMS style.
Do you think that BRs kind of go a little bit beyond that, though? And they have kind of like specific things that are all in common, kind of like the same reason a MOBA is not an RTS.
I think you're getting totally into semantics, and it does not fucking matter
on any of this. Good point.
Like, there's no reason to discuss this because we'll just let people on the forums do it, and then they'll decide.
You're absolutely right. Let me just shut up, JP.
No, I just see that devolving very quickly to like a forum conversation. I was like, why the fuck are we having this conversation? So let's talk about something else. Co, you're still you finished Fallout 3 and all the DLC this morning.
We're done. We finished Fallout 3.
Nice.
We
have
all the DLC and everything on hardest difficulty. It was awesome. Like 100%. We did so much in this last playthrough.
100%.
And what was no, we didn't 100% it. There's still a lot of like the overall.
Those games are really hard to 100%.
They can.
There's a lot of shit.
Yeah, I was just curious.
But what was really cool about this playthrough we did was the viewer who submitted the template, it was a Sherlock Holmes template, and it was specifically to try to piece together a lot of the little stories and stuff we saw in the different environments we went through. So like today, for instance, we were running through this tunnel, right, and it, underground, and we just, you know, there's a car and there's some boards leaned against each other and a motorcycle and, you know, some weird stuff around. And I remember specifically when I played this in the past that I just ran right through it. Well, this time I was like, okay, you know, let's see what's going on here. And what we find is there's a skeleton hanging from his chin from a light. And then if you look down and look around, there's a car with two ramps on each side. And then if you look down the pipe, there's a motorcycle.
Huh.
And if you piece it all together, this dude tried to jump the car, got caught on the light, got killed. The second half of him kept going on the motorcycle, which is down the hall.
Nice.
And you can actually, if you actually follow it back, you can see like where the bloodstains are and where the bike shifted. And it was awesome. There's so much stuff like that in these games that it really blew me away. Everywhere we'd go, if you just take a second before you do anything and look around and kind of try to piece together, I can only imagine how long the level designers took on a lot of that stuff because they make stories just out of putting stuff in an environment. But it was cool. It was really fun. And I got to admit, I had a great time with it, but I'm really excited to get on to New Vegas.
Yeah.
That is one of my favorites. And I'm kind of toying with this idea of turning it into 100% where we would do all the DLC, all main quest, side quest, and all the map.
You went that through this kind of faster than I thought you would. Is that kind of what you're saying, thinking as well? Maybe that's why you're making 100%?
Well, I always knew it would be quicker. I even when I said August 15th for the start of all this, I knew I'd probably be done before November. But it's not so much that I feel I'm going too quick through it, because there's actually tons of great games out right now to play. Between Rocket League, I'm still playing CS every now and then, the H1Z1 stuff, and there's all these indie games that came out, like Empyrean, the Base Builder, there's Wanderlust Adventures, there's tons of stuff to play.
Right.
But I did kind of want to just get as much of this Fallout kind of under our belt and on YouTube and stuff to kind of make a go-to. You want to know everything about Fallout before 4? Here you go.
Gotcha.
And and that's kind of what's been pushing it along.
Cool, cool. I finished up the Metal Gear Solid playthrough, which I'm really...
How was that?
That was really good. The first game, obviously, was like PS1. There was no HD version of it. That was a little rough, but it was only like... I think it was like maybe an 11-hour game, so it was two streams very quick. All the games were really two streams.
How did you play it?
What do you mean?
Did you download it or like?
No, I played it on PS3. They have. Do I have it here? Yeah. So they. This
did
came
we
out.
Just have a sound explosion?
What do you mean? I don't
apparently,
know.
Apparently, RIP ears.
Everyone says that happens during the stream. It might be something with XSplit where it hits a certain amount of data written on a VOD or something that it does an audio blip. I don't know. I've never heard it on our end. But yeah, anyways.
Sorry about that, dudes.
Yeah, sorry if that. I don't know why that's happening. So this is it. If you can see that, it's coming in backwards. But it's the Metal Gear Solid Legacy Collection. It's got every Metal Gear Solid, including Peace Walker, which I did not play.
Why didn't you play that one?
So I wanted like the main four games. Peace Walker was PSP, I think. So it was a handheld game. And that's actually, it is the game that happens in the chronological order right before 5. It's coming out on September 1st. I'm just going to read about it. You can read about it in Ground Zeroes. They have like a full explanation of everything that happened there. Parents really, it's super tedious and it has like 40 hours of actual gameplay in it. I didn't want to play a PSP version that's been HDified for 40 plus hours. So I just didn't. But yeah, so I did Metal Gear Solid 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I played Ground Zeroes, which is the one that came out like 6 months ago or whatever on the PS4 and PC. So,
Play the one with the robot guy? The like action one?
Oh, Revengeance? No, I had played that before on stream. So that's actually a point of contention. A lot of people... Apparently, Kojima said in an interview that was canon, but before that, no one considered it to be canon, and it happened so far in the story chronologically that it just wasn't really applicable to 5, which is coming out, which takes place in the 80s. But that story, like that entire game, it's such a fucking weird game because the story is so convoluted. So fucking convoluted. To where if you just come into that game not knowing anything about it, you're going to be... probably lost.
I tried and I couldn't do it. I was like, yeah, I'm done.
This is footage from the fourth one.
You completed all of them in 2 weeks?
Yeah, each one was about 2 or 3 days. It wasn't that long of a playthrough. Each one took about 10 to 12 hours with 4 taking 15 hours.
When does the new one come out?
The first. So the Tuesday after we get packs from PAX Prime. Or get back from PAX Prime.
See, I've kind of wanted been doing one, but I didn't like a franchise playthrough of that, but I didn't.
You could get through, if you did a 10 to 12 hour stream, you could probably get through all of them in a week and a half, I would think. They're not that bad. I also played on normal. I did not play on the hardest difficulty. Difficulty in these games like amps the fuck up to where it's just really, really difficult.
Yeah, if I would want to do it, it would be for story only. I haven't even seen any of them. In fact, it was kind of unfortunate. I tried to drop in your stream a few times, and one of them I dropped in like right at a very crucial point in 2 where the chat was just flipping out, and I was just like, oh God, I gotta go.
There's so much of that.
I haven't seen any of those. I've heard they're great, the stories.
They are, but it's in a very, like, they're great in a Metal Gear Solid way. Like, you have to play these games and know that the story is completely fucking ridiculous. So much so that one of the main plot points that continues throughout the entire series has to do with someone taking over someone's body by having their arm grafted onto them. So if you understand that, then you understand what you're getting into. It's really fucking bizarre. But one of the things that was really cool at Gamescom last week, they had a 40-minute video that Konami put out showing gameplay from 5. It's going to be fucking super fun because it's open world and none of the other games have been that. They've all been super linear.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That could be cool.
It's open world in a sense, yeah. And there's like missions and stuff. I guess I could show the video. It's gonna get claimed immediately on YouTube.
Oh, that would get yeah.
Yeah, because Konami's a bunch of assholes. But
so if we wanted to do a full playthrough, what systems would we need?
You just need one. You just need a PS3. I played everything on the PS3.
Just a PS3.
Yeah.
Konami's a bunch of assholes. I love that.
Dude, they are. You can't put anything up.
Down, down, left, right, kiss my ass.
they're into the fucking casino pachinko. I don't even know how to say that.
That's
term.
A license to print money, man.
Yeah. but it looks really crazy. One of the other things they're doing, they announced last week, is so the idea of a mother base is something that's been in kind of a common thread throughout all the games. And in 5, you're going to be able to build your own base and like recruit people from the open world, and they'll show up at your base. And then as you expand this more and more, eventually they said once you grow it to a certain size and you have enough of an area for it to occur, you can have people invade your base any moment you're online. So like if you're in the middle of a mission, it could just be like intruder detected. And then you have to go back to your base, and it's a 1v1 scenario where like you're defending your base and they're trying to get to your mother core. And then if you defend it or they do attack it, they can steal stuff from your base and bring it back to their base. And then once they're done, you can attack their base immediately. So it's like the first time they've ever done anything like that when it comes to the series. And it seems like it's going to be really cool. I would definitely say if you're a fan and you haven't watched the GamesCon footage of it yet, they go into super hyper detail with it, and it's going to be a lot of fun. And there's not that.
Sounds like a pretty creative PvP system.
It is, yeah. It's. I'm interested in, and I kind of hope it goes the way of like you remember Watch Dogs multiplayer. I kind of hope it's like that niche type multiplayer, which was a lot of fun. So what was that, Zeke? What were we laughing at?
No, I was laughing at Watchdog multiplayer.
Oh, did you not play that? It was fantastic.
No, I didn't. Is it?
It was actually the best part of that game.
It was actually really developed. Yeah. It was pretty impressive. It's just there was so much controversy and shit surrounding it. It never really took off, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But it had a really cool system.
Elohim was really into it. I think he was actually ranked maybe like top 10 in the world.
He got really top 10. Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I picked up Watch Dogs like everybody else, and it just made me want to play Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah. That's true. That came out. Did that come out before MGS5? Or sorry, not MGS5. GTA 5, or was that after?
GTA 5.
I think that was after, right? Because Watch Dogs came out on the PS4. That's where that came out, right? I think
May 27th.
They were close.
Is when Watch Dogs came out.
Okay, chat will tell us. Ella was ranked one, apparently, according to the chat. But yeah.
Oh yeah, GTA 5 came out earlier by almost half a year.
Yeah, so I finished that up. I think I'm a fan of the franchise playthroughs. Doing that sold me on it. And so I think I'm going to do Halo next, because Halo 5 comes out on the 27th of October. So I'm going to play through all the Halo games, which is actually a little bit daunting because it's like 60 plus hours, because there's a lot of fucking Halo games. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, Reach, and ODST. Which will be fun to play through. But I can do that all co-op
ODST,
as well.
Man.
Did you ODST. Like it or no?
I actually played it with my wife. Me and my wife co-op through the entire game.
You
and
liked it?
I liked a lot of it. Yeah. I don't want to spoil anything. Okay. So.
Yeah, that ODST is the one I've actually... That's the one Halo game I have not played. But I've played like 1, 2, 3, 4. I think we're going to do it on Legendary as well. Just because those games are actually...
Nice.
They're not that bad on.
Are you
going to
co-op through it at all? Are you
going to
do it with
viewers
or subs?
I'm not sure who exactly. I have a couple people in mind. I got to see if their schedules work out for it. Because like 60 hours is a lot to devote. They're basically going to have to do the same thing I am. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see. The first one's only 2-player co-op. The other ones are 4-player. So we can just have like someone pop in for a night as well. That might be fun. But yeah, that's about what I've been streaming apart from all the other shows. I don't think there's been anything really
I just since we're kind of like in the middle of stuff, I just received stuff from St. Jude for, you know, the streaming stuff. I had no idea that I was getting this shit. I got it in the like FedEx, and I was like, holy shit, I had no idea. I actually got an Xbox One and a PS4.
Nice.
From them, and I don't own an Xbox One, so I'm keeping that. and I promised someone I'd play Halo with them.
Nice.
Halo 5? But all the Halos.
Oh, okay.
Probably gonna do like an entire Halo thing.
Yeah.
But I wanted to say this because you know it's a big forum. At PAX, I'm taking the PS4 down there, and anybody who was in the same dude, like Yuko, anybody else that went down to Memphis, we're gonna sign it, and then we're gonna do that eBay thing.
eBay thing.
They have like a special St. Jude eBay page that they're gonna do money. So we're gonna have everybody that was there autograph the PS4. And I just wanted to get the word out that we're going to be, you know, putting that up on eBay for St. Jude and raffling that off. Also, I wanted to tell anybody who's listening who was there at the in Memphis at the St. Jude thing that you need to come sign this at PAX.
Cool. Good stuff.
Awesome. Yeah, that eBay stuff. There's some fun announcements coming down that pipeline.
Nice. Yeah, I didn't even know that was a thing. So that's cool. Yeah, I'm starting to get. We're 15 days away from PAX Prime? 14 days from PAX Prime? I'm starting to get pretty fucking excited. I'm pretty stoked for that.
I'm nervous.
You're nervous? What? Why are you nervous?
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing there.
Oh, like work-related
That's
stuff?
The best part.
Yeah.
there's a lot of things where a lot of people have asked me to do stuff, and I'm just like, give me like a couple days to think about it, because I don't know if I want to devote myself to like working there just yet.
I am purposefully blocking off large blocks of like not doing anything during this time.
Yeah.
Nope. It's already reserved.
Yeah.
Nope. I've been a whole day like that. I've learned my lesson in that regard, man.
I want to ask something, but I don't. Here, I'll just ask you in chat. Because I don't want to say it on stream. Are you doing that?
Oh my God, JP.
What?
No, I'm just kidding. No, I'm not.
Yeah, no, you're not. You are gonna? Okay. I might do it as well.
Oh, like at PAX?
Yeah.
I have not been informed nor invited.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Yeah, I was asked. I just don't know if I'm going to do it, Co.
But yes, if you have any connections, yes. So we're being a little clandestine right now.
No, we're just being assholes right now. Don't worry.
Eat a dick, chat.
Let's talk a little bit about some stuff. I kind of wanted to have Tally on this week, but I kind of didn't either because it would have taken over the show. They had World of Warcraft expansion come out last Thursday, and it like ruled the news airwaves of gaming, which I don't know why every time the WoW expansion comes back, or it gets announced, people just fucking lose their mind and resub to that game. I was almost one of them.
Dude, I can't even tell you the name of it. I don't even know what's in it.
Yeah, you didn't follow it up. Yeah.
I just don't care. And I'm sorry if you love WoW out there and that's your thing, but what's the big new thing? What's the big new hype for this expansion?
They're adding to the game. Probably not the best person to ask. So they have artifacts, which I think you can start leveling from level 100 to level 110. So it's going to be an item that stays with the character that actually has a talent tree within the item. And they look really cool. They have like 5 different looks to them, which I think you can change on your own. They announced a new hero class, and that is the Demon Hunter, which is basically Illidan. Everyone's going to be like a bunch of Illidans. And he actually has double jump. So like a real double jump is going to be in the game, which is kind of interesting. Then they add like the raids and stuff. Like, do what?
What's the role of a DPS?
No, so it can actually be a tank or a DPS. I don't think it could be a healer.
Shadow Knight? Didn't they just do a Death Knight recently?
But Death Knight can also be a tank or a DPS as well. It can be both. But this is the Demon Hunter, which the tank looks kind of like a tanky. I don't know. Everything looks like Illidan to me. I looked at everything that came out, and it was kind of like Burning Crusade 2.0, which a lot of people regard as like the best WoW expansion. So I think that's kind of why they went with that.
Yeah, Burning Crusade was pretty sick. I was playing at that time.
Yeah. So a lot of people are super stoked for that.
Speaking of Blizzard.
Yeah.
Guess what I did, JP?
What'd you do?
I bought cards that I can't open yet either.
Oh, yeah. You spent the $60 or the $50 or whatever?
The $50, and I'm just sitting there staring at them. They have a little, and I'm not shitting you, they have a bow on them.
Yeah,
just to tease you. They're just, and they're sparkling to like, no.
They had one of the other things too. They did Star Citizen. They had a, what the fuck was the name of it? It was basically like them walking around in the, I don't even know what the social thing, where like you could shoot actual guns, like, and you had like a real person, not a ship. You were walking around in like the fucking, I can't speak today. I don't even know what the term is I'm trying to say. They had like a long demo of that.
First person shooter?
Kind of, yeah. And they showed like them finding the remnants of a ship, and then they repaired the ship, and then they like flew away.
This
was
the big Star Citizen thing they showed off.
Yeah.
So you saw it?
Yeah, well, no, I mean, there's a video of it. Yeah, I watched the video of it.
I haven't seen it yet. What did you think?
It looks cool. Like, the idea's there. It was, the stream had like a weird 24 FPS. I felt like it was 24 FPS. I don't know if that was the actual FPS the game was running at. It looked odd. Multi-crew. There you go. That's the term that they were using. The multi-crew demo. But yeah, it looks cool. Like, that game looks fucking crazy as usual. Anything they show from that game is just bonkers with how fucking large it's going to be. And it was, I guess they announced that was the multi-crew module is what that was that they were showing.
Now, when you say how large it's gonna be,
yeah,
like, okay, I'm sorry. Just can you give me a synopsis of Star Citizen, because people have been talking about it, and I'm like, I feel like I get it, and then I don't, and then
it is literally. Do you remember Wing Commander?
Did you? Yeah. Ever play?
So, it's Wing Commander on crack, where you can go anywhere.
No. I'm sorry. I didn't phrase that. I guess. What, like, is it out? Is it?
No.
Like,
okay. Star Citizen is one of the largest crowdfunded projects ever. Now, here's the thing.
It is the largest.
I knew that.
When the project was announced, they said they were going to do all this stuff, persistent multi-module or persistent universe module, first-person module, dogfighting module. And what they've been doing is over the last few years, they've been slowly releasing components. Now, the next big component is the first-person shooter module, as far as I know. And they've already released the dogfighting module and the hangar module. So they basically announced the huge project, said everything they want from the game, which they really, they're promising the moon. Like, there's so much to this game. Just like JP said, it's like one of the quasi-better Starship Sims in the past on crack. Like, it's everything has been, enhanced, better, plus big. And they're kind of now releasing ships that you can buy for real-life money, which goes towards a project. They are releasing the modules slowly. And in their words, and I got to say I kind of agree with them, the next module is the social module, apparently, not the FPS module.
Yeah, but like, okay. What does that mean?
But yeah, the big thing now, and the reason it's causing so much controversy, is they're releasing these ships that cost a lot of money. Their development cycle is very slow, but they're taking the Blizzard route with it, where they're saying, look, we know we're being slow, we know too, but we're not going to release a product that we don't think really lives up to the promises we made. You can't fault them for that. Yeah. No. Now, a lot of, though, people that have given thousands of dollars in some cases are kind of sitting here going, and this is where all the bad stuff about Star Citizen comes from. Oh, what are they doing with our money? It's a vaporware, blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, just like JP, in this last big Star Citizen thing, they're clearly making progress.
Yeah, they really
are. It's just not at the speed everyone would like. So did that answer most of your questions about it?
Yeah, it totally did. I'm just like, this is going to be like a monthly subscription thing that you do?
I think there's going to be multiple different things. I don't know if a monthly subscription is part of them, but they have said many times that they're going to let you pretty much buy what you want to use. So it's kind of, but at the same time, if you buy a small package, you get access to like almost all of it. Like, I think someone in chat, correct me if I'm wrong here, but I think it's the $49 package gets you access to like every major module or something.
Well,
like,
the dogfighting modules,
stuff changes up time, though, so.
The dogfighting module is free for all on the 19th of August. So you don't even have to buy
into
that.
Oh, cool. So they're also releasing some for free? Awesome. Yeah, and like people in chat are saying, there's apparently no sub. I thought there was a sub option, but apparently there's not even a sub option. And it's a one pay, and you get whatever level you purchase at that point.
Okay. So, there's enough of it released that will keep, like, if I went and delved into it right now, there's totally enough that'll keep me interested. right now?
Not necessarily. Right now, there's the
hanger module. Depends how much reading you want to do.
well, right now there's the hanger module, which lets you walk around a very nice looking hanger, and you can get in the ships that you own on your account. And then there's the dogfighting module. Now, if you're really into dogfighting, then maybe, because you know it's a pretty well developed space simulator that you can fly a bunch of different ships. There's different game modes, I think, now. There was only destruction ones when I played, but I think there's actually different game modes now. So if you're really big into flight sim, you could do it. But I think me and a lot of the other people, the big thing Star Citizen sold us was the concept of a really good space sim combined with all these different things, like multi-planet exploration, first person landing on them, going, you know, like all these different components working in unison is what really kind of makes us excited for the project. And we're not going to see that for years.
Yeah, that's like, honestly, when you said that, it sounds amazing. It honestly sounds like they're going to need the money they made to make this fucking game.
100%.
Yeah. They may. Well, yeah.
Not 100%, but that's what everyone hopes, right?
It depends on how they do it. If they're going to go like the GTA 5 route on it and put in, you know, like voice actors and all these really expensive things, they could go over budget potentially. I mean, look at what was GTA's budget, like some crazy amount of money. So they can easily spend all the money they have. It's just a question of, you know, are they going to utilize the resources properly? And I think that's a big point of contention right now is you have all this money, Star Citizen. Why is it going so slowly? Like, are you know, why isn't this money being managed better? Why are you still accepting money when things haven't been delivered? Like that's where all this murkiness comes in. But at the same time, I'm personally, as time moves forward, especially after the last big dump, I'm feeling better about it. I was pretty skeptical about Star Citizen for a while, but I'm becoming more on board with the let's just wait a few years and see what they come up with, and hopefully it'll be really good.
I'm sorry, I just got to take that out of context real quick.
Oh God.
After the last big dump, I'm feeling pretty good about it.
There you go.
I should have said after the last big info dump.
It's like fight. Phrasing. Are we still saying phrasing? Are we still saying that?
Phrasing.
So we got 30 minutes left in the show. There's two or three topics that I don't know if we want to discuss. One I posted in Skype. You guys say yes or no to that.
I have no idea. I don't know what that is.
Co, do you want to talk? Do you know what that is?
I'm intrigued.
I don't know if I just want to draw attention to it. I'm very reluctant to do so.
Well, we fucked him on the other thing. Let's talk about
that.
All right,
we'll talk about it a little bit. So there's been this weird thing on Twitch. Apart from that, I think there's been like two or three people that have been doing it. It's like this weird fake crying thing on stream on Twitch where like they get a shit ton of viewers and it's just like this person cries and they get a lot of viewers because of, and they're just crying and playing a game. And I'm not kidding. Like there's someone right now that has
fetish.
There's someone that has like 16,000 viewers right now, and all they're doing is crying and playing League. And that was at like 26,000 last night.
Now, are we
talking about crying that better.
Happiness from events occurring or just crying because they're sad?
Both. It's like a character that these people are putting on, and the thing is that they cry. And people watch them play League of Legends and cry.
So the premise is that, but is it obvious they're not actually crying?
They look to be real.
Person needs help.
No. It is very much a character, but I think the tears are real.
I think the people are saying a name in the chat, and I think I got a tweet about that or something. It's like, you think that's bad? Check this shit out.
It's just weird. It's a weird fad that's happening. I mean, I'm not saying that it's a bad thing or a good thing. It's just a fucking weird fad on Twitch. Like I linked it if you want to see it right real quick on, I'm not going to show it on stream, but Zeke, if you want to watch that stream for 5 seconds, it's like they just cry on stream, and I just want to know what you guys thought about that, because it's a weird fad.
Well, it sounds like you go to
like a foot like fetish.
Foot fetish, yeah, it sounds like something like that, like a cry stream. Oh, good. Thank God a cry stream's on. I mean, I don't understand it.
Yeah. It's very odd. It's very weird.
What?
Yeah, it's kind of weird. It's
That's very uncomfortable.
I don't know.
That's
people not... People are really upset about it on Twitch.
Why are they upset about it? What makes them upset?
I think it spawns from jealousy. They see the numbers and they're like, well, that's dumb. Like this person's literally crying on stream and they have this many viewers. Like I'm jealous and that's dumb. I think is where most of that's coming from, but I just think it's a weird thing that's like happened on, like, why the fuck does this exist?
So but why, dude, why would you shy away from talking about it?
Because I just don't want to draw attention right here, to it, dude. Is the main thing. But.
Okay.
It's sensationalist.
Yeah.
It's something that you're not going to find on 99% of other streams. What happens the second someone falls asleep on stream? Like wildfire.
Yeah.
It spreads through Twitch and people are linking it. Dude, this guy fell asleep. This guy fell asleep. You need to come see this. And, you know, all of a sudden everyone else is like, where'd all my numbers go? It's the same thing, dude. It's something that's on one to five channels on Twitch that's not anywhere else. So, hey, this girl's crying. Yo, check this out. Dude, you right now. Yeah, you know, it's just sensationalist stuff. Well, In fact, when I was here, I saw someone say they're going to go link this to every channel they're in.
Yeah, no, so that's like, the thing. It's caught on like wildfire and that.
Now, what I'm wondering is it, do they do that every day?
She was doing it last night and again tonight, or again today as well. So
they do that every day?
I guess so. There was a different streamer altogether last week, and I don't know where that person's at. I don't know if they're still streaming or what. I haven't actually looked into it. I just know that like every night I'll see it starts. It's kind of a slow process where someone will be streaming on, or someone will be tweeting, and then like another person's tweeting about it, and then they start like tweeting back and forth one another, and then like some more people jump into it, and then it like Ko was saying, it's very sensational where everyone's like, "What the fuck?" It's a very bizarre thing.
I think Cody, that was a bad analogy as far as someone falling asleep on the stream, because that's like, you know, that's a one time like random weird thing. It's like, oh shit, he fell asleep. But this time, this is a planned thing.
Yeah, well, it's 100% planned.
Here's the thing, Zeke. This is the first time I think we've seen this kind of stuff. So I think for 90% of the people in here, they don't know it's planned. They weren't here yesterday or the day before, or they think it's just some multi day breakdown. Basically, it's watching a train wreck. You're watching cars crash. Right. It's the same thing. You're watching someone break down in front of you and lose control of their emotions.
Right.
And some people, that's the butter. That's the cheddar. That's what they want to watch entertainment to see the, oh, my God, did you see that? Like, oh, dude, she's so stressed. She's crying in her hands now.
Yeah.
Did you hear what she just said to that guy who just donated her $20? She just cussed him out. You know, like, it's...
It's bizarre. It's bizarre as fuck, man.
It's pulp. It's just... Ugh.
That's why I want to bring it, because it's just a weird fucking trend on Twitter.
Here's the thing.
Go ahead.
Something like that sounds too gimmicky to last for a long time.
Right.
Yeah. I think it's a fad. I really think it's fad, and that's fine. That's why it doesn't bother me too much. Like, that...
I don't think I can't speak for YouTube, but I don't get like upset when I see this. I'm just like, what? Like, well, this is weird. I can't even say anything else about it.
They
can
watch whatever they want.
Yeah.
And frankly, I mean, think of it this way. If you have someone that's watching you on Twitch and they get told, hey, there's a girl crying on another channel, you could come check this, you know, you need to come check this out, and they leave your stream to go do that, you know, are you really going to be like, man, I wish that guy that wanted to watch girls cry was still watching me? You know, it's like, if that's what people want to see, don't take it personally. That's what they want to see.
Right.
Don't let it affect your mood or attitude. I mean,
right.
You know what? Are you going to start crying on stream to get it back?
Well,
who cares?
We should. Let's try it, guys. Let's see how. Let's try it for a week. We'll just see what happens.
I always fall back on the Godfather argument, where it's like, I got no problem with how someone makes money.
Like, right. Right. Yeah.
Doesn't bother my ass.
Yeah.
As long as it doesn't affect us, it's not our business.
Yep. Like I have a very close friend who makes it his living to do stupid shit, get drunk, and play video games. Well, maybe not get super drunk anymore, but like play video games on Twitch. Like that's like his job. It's the Sour Coolie Show.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like he does stupid shit and drinks, and that's his show, and I love it. But, like, I got no problem with that. I got no problem with her crying. I got no problem with someone, like, being a character every time they stream. Yeah. I got no problem with that either. It's just they're making money the way they can, and as long as they're not breaking TOS, I got no problem with it. Just like teaming in fucking Ark.
And we don't know if those people tried for a year doing it the way we do and just weren't successful and had to find their way. You know, they could have tried harder than we ever did in some cases to get to the point where they are right now. It's not our place to judge, or, you know, again, as long as it doesn't affect us, you know, then whatever. Do whatever they want.
I've just seen a bunch of on things not Twitch, on sites that I frequent that are not Twitch, like threads have popped up and be like, Twitch has a serious problem. And I'm like, what? Like, what the fuck are you talking about? Why are you bringing this up on the site if it's a serious problem? You're only helping this if you think it's a serious problem. I don't understand their line of thinking. But some of the other things that were, I thought was an interesting article. Did you guys see this article from The Verge this week titled YouTube is now better at live streaming than Twitch? This was all over the internet.
How did I miss that
part? Excuse me?
What?
Yeah. So the title is YouTube is now better at live streaming than Twitch. And it was about mostly about the international championships over the weekend. I don't know. It seems kind of like a clickbaity article, but I read through it for the most part. It's kind of interesting. Like, they quote that like YouTube has 1080p 60 FPS, but it's still at 3,500 bit rate. So it looks shit. Like, it looks like complete
shit.
Let's
just be perfectly clear though. YouTube has not yet launched their full gaming streaming service, correct?
Right,
it's
right,
not
right.
Out yet.
I don't think they were speaking to that. I think they were simply saying the platform that, not YouTube Gaming, but like the streaming service that YouTube provided.
The hardware.
Yeah,
the tech and hardware behind it.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's arguable.
Yeah.
That's arguable. Okay. That title is not what that means at all.
Right.
That's a really clickbaity title.
Yeah.
But I think especially after some of the stuff we've seen, like, dude, it's Google. They're a billion-dollar fiber-creating infrastructural behemoth.
Right.
If their stuff wasn't better than Twitch's, I mean, that'd be ridiculous.
One of the biggest points in the article was that now on YouTube, it's the quote is, if Twitch is regular TV, YouTube is TV with the basic TiVo box attached to it. And that's because they were citing the rewind feature on YouTube. So you can go to any part of a live broadcast and watch something you've missed. Or like, start the broadcast an hour too late, go back to the beginning of it, and then skip to the actual games and like go past. They were watching the international, so they would watch, they would skip all of the analytical crap and just go straight from game to game to game. And that's something that they really liked. But that was kind of like the main thing of it. I don't know. It was a very weird article. And I guess we're obviously a little biased,
though,
but
I mean, you know, Google and YouTube is doing its own thing and making its own developments. And the whole YouTube gaming thing is very new, and Twitch is definitely doing things to kind of attempt to catch up. But I mean, at this point, like, Twitch hasn't even really had a chance to respond
right
to a lot of the things that make YouTube better. I mean, the YouTube gaming announcement was a handful of months ago. You know, it takes a long time to develop real tangible infrastructural advancements. So with that being said, man, I mean, it's not really fair. So when YouTube Gaming basically announces, like, hey, here we are and here's all our new features, you can't really immediately just go, okay, they're better. You know,
right.
It's like, okay, now that there's a competitor to Twitch, now that they know what the playing field's like, let's give them a little bit and, you know, let's see what's going to be comparable. It doesn't for a second mean that they're, like, you know,
right.
Everyone go to YouTube. They're better. I mean, that's ridiculous.
It's very sensational. The other article was on Kotaku, and this one was YouTube's gaming app is really, really good is the title. Then the first line of it is, meet YouTube's gaming app. Do you use Twitch on your phone? This is better. And they go into like full on detail about YouTube gaming's app. They have a little video for it. I'm not going to play it because obviously this is Kotaku's footage, but I did not look at the video yet. I probably will after the stream. But
wait, what does it stream?
I don't know. I don't really know. This is apparently, you can't even get this. They're looking at the alpha or the beta of this app. Starting with this app, YouTube Gaming hasn't gone live yet. It's planned for a late 2015 launch. But a test version of its Android app has leaked out this week. So installed it and gave it a workout. They said it was better than the Twitch app. So I don't know. It's kind of weird how like all these sites are popping up with these type of articles. I just thought it was interesting point of topic.
Kind of goes into what the last thing we were talking about, though. Again, you know, Google is, they're a huge, huge, massive company. They have an entire OS on their cell phones. Their mobile apps are probably going to be a little bit better. But again, that doesn't mean anything about the streaming being better or anything like that.
Right.
But on that Kotaku article, though, did it peg any reasons why they felt it was better? Like, are there any tangible, like, good reasons?
I think that's...
I'm interested.
That's in the video. Let me just skim through it here. Blah, blah, blah. Google is hoping with a slicker design and superior tech of its own offerings can win folks over. I'm very impressed with how clean, simple, and functional the app is, to the point where I think this is way better than Google's actual YouTube app. Below is a little guided tour you might want to play in full screen so you can actually read it. I guess I can play this and just see what it looks like on my end.
The thing I'm a little confused about is a huge part of a streaming app is watching a stream. Now, yeah. I'm assuming if this app was leaked, I don't think there's people just randomly streaming to no audience on a beta YouTube thing right now. It's like, how are you going to judge an app meant for streaming if you can't use it for streaming?
There are streams, at least according to this. There is a stream with 8 people watching a Rocket League stream. And a lot of them also have VODs from YouTube, which is, I guess, how they're going to handle the VOD system on YouTube gaming. I don't know. They've got like a game page as well for Rocket League, which is what I'm looking at here. That has like full information about what Rocket League is and the fact that you can like search, you can add that to your games and then have games or streams always pop up that are from that game. IGN was streaming there. What is this? They were streaming some Fallout New Vegas hardcore stream. I don't know. It's weird. I haven't watched this video too much, so I just wanted to see what you guys thought about it. It's weird, though, that all these articles are, like, popping up out of nowhere this past week. I'm like, YouTube gaming is better than Twitch. Very sensational.
Now, what is the legality or, like, are there restrictions on, like, because, I mean, I'm not, like, accusing anybody of anything. I just, like, can you pay for that shit?
I mean, you can pay for
anything.
Can you
pay for positive advertising? Absolutely.
Positive advertising. Could Twitch, like, legally pay Kotaku to say, like, YouTube sucks, Twitch is great?
You could, but I think your moral ethics on the site, which I really don't want to get into, go out the fucking window if you do that, especially if people find out about it.
Right. You can, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it depends on. I mean, that's what ruins news websites' reputation if right. that kind of thing goes out. It's all behind. Like, if that stuff does happen, it's obviously never meant to be public. It's behind. It's dirty, and everyone involved is dirty. But does it happen? Yes.
It probably happens.
Yes, it happens.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Okay. Unfortunately.
I didn't know if there was like some form of like restrictions like regarding journalistic integrity on the internet, because I'm not like boned up on that or whatever. I'm actually curious, like, as to, like, are there certain sites that are accredited in saying we do not take payment for stories?
Every
like you
site
have to go through
I think,
something.
I think every site
sign
has
a
that.
Contract saying we won't take your money
I don't,
to put a story.
You
in.
Can't sign a contract with yourself, but
no news or no like opinionated site that has columns or anything like that, or even a news website. Honestly, if they skewed it enough, would ever need like they it's assumed that no one's ever doing that, so there would be no real need for anyone to say they are, because if you are doing that, you're immediately in the wrong, unless you are a sponsored site and you have sponsored thing, you know, this article is sponsored by Intel or something like that. Okay. That happens a lot, that's fine, but if you know, there would be no need to say, hey, we're a legit site, look at our badge in the top, because everyone wants you to think they're that, if that makes sense.
Right. No, that absolutely makes sense. I know they want you to think that, but I didn't know if there was, I don't know, some way to be accredited that you wouldn't, that your site doesn't do that or something. I don't know. I'm in a dream world. I'm in a fantasy. Please, integrity, right? Everything, like, the internet has integrity, right?
I think that's the dream.
Yeah, that's it. That's the dream.
Hashtag
that's what I'm talking
about. The dream. That's right.
Yeah,
that's
right. Hashtag the dream. I honestly think, you know, as YouTube gaming ramps up more and more to its launch, you're going to start to see a lot of articles like this, because we're talking about them here on the show. Like, they're very clickbaity, and they're good points of conversation as well. Because immediately, like, the chat just went fucking full-on crazy mode, just discussing it rampantly. So it's obviously something a lot of people care about.
There's absolutely no question that when YouTube gaming ramps up, it's going to be a David versus Goliath situation. I mean, when you have Google and YouTube throwing their full weight behind a streaming service, and you see it advertised on every site you go to, and it pops up in all your Google things. I mean, Twitch is the big one right now, because we're basically the heart and brain of streaming. You know, we have the community, we have the amazing people that run Twitch. Like, it's a very cognitive
experience.
Group, and it's a very awesome group of people. Everyone, you know, everyone has a lot of nice things to say about them. But once YouTube gaming gets going, you know, 5, 6, 10 months a year from now, I mean, these roles are going to switch. And I think it's going to be, you know, we're going to see tons and tons of articles like this coming up.
I just don't know. Like, if YouTube takes over, I don't know what I'm going to do. If YouTube, like, if they start taking over Twitch, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Watch the viewership spike up. Keep it up, Zeke. Keep it up.
Keep it going, Zeke. I'm going to put crying in parentheses.
Now,
in the
do
title.
They like loud crying or soft crying? Like, crying.
Both.
Both. Or do they want you're crying so hard you start puking, like, oh god.
Now, Zeke, you need to randomly pick a line or two out of chat and then make a comment on it about how it hurts you.
Yeah.
And then just amp it up. Do that about every 10 seconds.
That's such a weird fucking thing. I just can't wrap my mind around it.
How did you say that to me? Negative.
I can't tell if we're being really insensitive or funny right now.
You're such
if they were really in pain and crying, I think we'd be insensitive. But it's a character, so I think we can make fun of it.
They'd turn the fucking camera off.
I think that's that's what I thought. I was like, okay, if it was real, they wouldn't be on Twitch. But what if Twitch is their escape? You know, what if streaming makes them feel better and they're having a really bad day and they actually are crying. Now all of a sudden I'm like, I don't want to be that guy yelling at a crying person.
Have you seen the chat? That's going to make nobody feel better.
Yeah. It's interesting. It turns Twitch into a circle jerk of hate. It really does, which is, I hope that doesn't spread to other channels.
I really don't like that it's a fad.
Yeah.
It's such a weird, like, that's...
It's just a bizarre thing, for sure.
Yeah. It's weird. It's weird to think that viewing someone in that much distress is entertainment. But then again, I mean, I guess there's movies and videos, and we love when we see our favorite actors, you know, have these big moments.
So. Remember that, it makes
one
me
of
think...
My, one of my most viewed YouTube videos is a chest waxing and a mouse trap.
It makes me think
dad.
Of that, do you remember that...
To be fair, I think that's just because I wanted to see Zeke tits, though. Let's be honest.
True. Do you remember that fan video of the person defending Britney Spears that cried?
Yeah.
Leave Britney alone.
That's immediately what I went to mentally. I was like, huh, I guess this is coming back. And I guess
that's
on Twitch.
A really interesting parallel to draw. Yeah. Because that rocketed that.
It
he
did.
Had, he
it
like branded himself. That, he went crazy with that.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, that's kind of interesting.
Yeah.
Oh man, it's there's so many different perspectives on this kind of stuff. It's almost like you don't want to say something without remembering to think of all of them.
Right. Right. Yeah. It's a weird thing. It's a weird thing. Well, I think that.
Yeah. If we went through everything, it's like if we went through everything on Twitch that gets viewers or makes money that was confusing or I didn't get it, we'd be here we'd be here for all day and next week. Like, there's so much shit. Like, I go in like, oh, yeah, 8,000 viewers, and I'm like, this is fucking awful. I don't understand this at all. What's going on here?
I just try to understand everything, and I've come to the conclusion that I just can't. I just can't make sense of some shit.
But then again, people come into my channel, and they're like, who would watch this loud, fucking, boorish, vulgar oaf? Video games badly.
Dude, same thing for mine.
I get that all the time, Zeke. Dude, why did you tell us to raid this guy?
You get those comments. I get the, whenever we're front page for roleplay, it's like, the fuck are these nerds doing? I'm like, huh.
I thought Twitch was for gaming.
Yeah, we get that. That's probably number one comment. And then there's a lot, yeah. I love being front page. It's one of the funniest things because people just come into the chat. And just say
that. It brings
them.
A whole little slice
it
into
does.
Your chat. It's just never there.
It's so fun. It's fun.
What's scary?
I know when I'm playing Fallout, when I hit front page, because that's inevitably every day, there's this certain little magic window where it's like, Fallout sucks. Fallout's for jerks. Why aren't you playing COD? This is like a first-person shooter that doesn't know what it's doing. You know,
right,
it's like, and then it'll be that way for like 15 minutes, and then it's back to smooth sailing.
Yep.
What's Gary? Please tell me what Gary is.
I don't even know what that is.
All day.
Gary's vault. Okay. The story of Gary. In vault,
is that from
in a certain vault. Basically, wow. In Fallout 3, there's this certain vault where there are cloning experiments going on, run by a small team, and they name their clones Gary. And you can search through this vault, and as you do, there's all these different Gary numbers that are attacking you. They can only say Gary. They only attack people that aren't Gary. They're basically this, it's little Gary microcosm, and they end up killing everyone who cloned them. So basically they clone a bunch of Garys. All they can say is Gary. All they do is like each other, and they just kill everyone else. And they completely take over the vault and run it into the ground.
That Gary. Sounds like those alien, or the, excuse me, the droids from Alien Isolation that walk around. May I help you?
Oh, yeah.
You look like you're in stress.
That stuff was pretty creepy. I remember that.
That was creepy.
I never played that game. Yeah. I should play that game.
You've never played Alien Isolation?
No, I watched a good bit of it. I was like, I know how long and boring it gets towards the end, but I know.
There's a lot of tacked on shit, but it's fantastic.
Yeah.
If you put on the hardest difficulty, it is pretty much like nail biting to the end. A lot of people played it on normal, but the hardest difficulty adds a lot more to it. So
yeah,
it is a great game.
I played it on hard too, man. It's fantastic. It's one of the most like suspenseful games I've ever played.
Huh.
Maybe I'll check. Like you are seriously like sneaking around as slow as you can, trying to avoid that, because that when that alien like is around, I'm physically sweating.
And dude, you see a shadow of a tail whip around outside of a room that you're in. You just, oh god, turn around, run back into your locker. Where's my locker? It's great.
Jesus.
Great.
Jesus. Yep. All right, let's do some shout-outs and call it a show. Next week we'll be on Zeke's channel, so you can catch us there on Wednesday at 3 o'clock Eastern over at twitch.tv/Ezekiel_II.
Yep. Gary Busey is actually going to be on the show. It's going to be fucking awesome. I'm kidding. That's a joke. That was a total lie.
Dude. Well, dude, after Kool-Aid Show and Andrew WK, I don't know what to think anymore, yeah. Man.
Don't let your streams be dreams, Zeke.
Don't let your streams be dreams. I haven't heard that yet. I can't believe I haven't heard that yet.
That's amazing.
That's good.
That is fucking great.
That's great. Did you just come up with that?
No, I ripped it off from someone on Twitter a while back.
You know who I've always wanted, though? Like, if anybody knows him, or I don't fucking know. I mean, there's 6,400 people here. I don't know. But if you can get us in contact, I always want to interview him or whatever. But if you can get contact with an angry video game nerd, can you send him our way? Anybody, if anybody, like slim 0.00%, 1%, I'd love to have him on.
I could probably, okay.
okay.
I might try. Cool. I can ask someone.
All right. JP's like, so how about next Wednesday at 6 p.m.? Is that good for you?
Yeah, maybe we'll have him on.
I forget I'm talking to JP, who fucking knows everybody.
I know a good amount of people, that's true. Zeke, do some shout outs.
All right. My name is Ezekiel III.
Zeke, do some shout-outs.
Thank you. I am known for my rage. Anyways, guys, my name is Ezekiel III. You can find me on Twitter and Twitch and YouTube, all the same, Ezekiel_III. I broadcast. I'm a variety streamer, but I'm doing Boshi right now because of a challenge that I had to complete. But I do play games at the end, like Rocket League and that kind of shit. So I'm on every day at 11 a.m. Pacific. Usually I tweet out if there's any change to the schedule. I will be at PAX and TwitchCon. See you there. And if you want like meet and greet autographs and stuff like that, I'll probably be hooking up with Co, which is what normally happens. But thank you. I want to thank Brad, Pluto. I want to thank Pluto for being on the show. Also want to thank Co and JP as normal. Okay, that's it. I'm done.
Okay, thank you. I'm glad you're done.
Thank you.
I'm back.
And I'm glad you're dead. I'm glad you're dead.
Co, do some shout outs.
Sure. Well, I'm Co. It's been a pleasure to be with you guys today. Big thank you to Zeke and JP as always. And a huge thanks to Pluto. That was really informative. And it's very exciting to see how that stuff goes. You can find me pretty much every morning. Normally I start at 8 a.m., but for the last couple weeks and probably for another week moving forward or so, I'll be starting at 10 a.m. We are starting our Fallout New Vegas playthrough tomorrow. Hopefully it will be modded and ready to go. We'll see how much I can get done tonight. We will start New Vegas tomorrow, but I don't know if all the modding will be complete, but we will see. But that's going to start at 10 a.m., and then we're going to be doing a full playthrough, hardest difficulty on hardcore, all the DLC, and it might be a 100% playthrough. We'll see. But anyway, as always, thanks again, and hope to see you there at 10.
What does hardcore mean? And is it you die once and you're good? You're done?
No. Hardcore is a special mode in New Vegas that means you have to eat realistically, sleep realistically. If you don't, you know, take care of the basic needs, then you'll start getting like pretty heavy stat hits. And it just kind of adds a layer of difficulty on top of very hard. Makes it more realistic. It's really cool.
I thought it was like die once and you have to restart. I thought it was. that kind of crazy.
I would not be good for that one. I died 67 times in the Fallout 3 one. And by the time you get to the end of those games, you're armed to the teeth. So
yeah,
that could be.
Well, hold on. Die once and you have to restart. I don't know what that's like. 38,000 plus times.
No. Well, it would actually be it would be if you died once.
So, Zeke, what we're talking about is every time you die, you'd have to restart Bashi.
You restart at the beginning of the game.
Oh.
What?
So how about after you beat Bashi, you can do that challenge?
There was I would do that if someone gave me like $1 million.
Mark that down.
Get it.
We have that in video.
Kickstarter.
We have that on video.
Kickstarter. Yeah,
39,000 times. Sorry. Thank you, Beezle Man.
There was some fucking like massive game that had hardcore mode in it, and was it Dark Souls? No. Whatever, I can't remember. I'm not going to spend time.
One of the BioShocks.
Maybe it was BioShock. Was it BioShock Infinite? BioShock
1999 mode. If you run out of money, you spawn in BioShock 1999 mode, the game ends.
No, that's what I had. I played 1999.
There's a really bad workaround to that, which is really unfortunate.
I played 1999
mode. Anytime you get to a hard point in that, you can hit escape and restart the chapter. So basically,
They're saying Diablo.
It's an easy out Diablo to that challenge, that. Unfortunately.
Obviously, Diablo is hardcore mode, guys. That's like a staple of that game. There was like a single player
Diablo
game,
well, very few games have hardcore mode that don't account for disconnects and shit. I've heard so many Diablo stories of thousands of hours lost in some cases from DCs and shit.
We played, we did a Diablo 3 hardcore stream with two of my other friends, and that actually happened. We were like level, I don't know, 14. And my friend lagged, died, and had to, like, stop streaming because she just died because of lag. There's nothing.
Oh, yeah.
It was very funny. It was very funny. I enjoyed that moment. Anyways, that's going to do it for the show. We'll see you guys next week on Zeke's channel. We don't know the guest. I'll figure that out this weekend. So, and then, Zeke, you're going to – are you? Can we talk about where you're going this weekend? Did you already say that? Aren't you going away
somewhere? Yeah, that's fine. I'm going Yeah, my brother, my older brother he's in the dark and he never watched Twitch anyways.
Oh, that's right. I want to know, you got to explain this a little bit. This is fucking bizarre.
I don't think it's that bizarre. But
I think
my
it's pretty fucking bizarre.
My brother is actually the team captain for Team USA Dodgeball, like the best dodgeball players in the United States. He's the team captain. He picked the dodgeball team for Team USA. The dodgeball championship is this weekend in Vegas, and that like world championships, like Mexico, Canada, China, Japan. I'm not sure exactly Australia. I'm not sure exactly what countries are coming, but it's the world championship in Vegas this weekend. And my brother, I can say, is arguably the best dodgeball player in the world. Like, it could be argued that he's the best dodgeball player in the world.
And dude, I asked you this in the, I think this was in the D&D thing or something, but is there anywhere we can watch this?
Now, here's the thing. I talked to my brother about it. They are definitely going to be recording it, but they said they will try and stream it depending on the internet connection where the gym is, that kind of thing. Awesome. So I will be tweeting
you
it.
Totally
if it's streaming,
that.
If it's streaming live, you can bet your fucking ass I will be tweeting it many times.
Awesome.
It's just, you said that, and I totally blanked that you said that. It's fucking bizarre.
Yeah.
It's a bizarre world, man. It's a weird world.
But yeah, that's why I'm going to be in Vegas from Friday to, I'll be come back Monday.
There you go. I'll do the rest of my shout-outs when we close out the show. We'll see you guys next week. We'll talk to Zeke about Vegas as well as have a guest and talk about streaming, I guess, for some reason. Anyways, we'll see you guys then. We're out. Have a good one. Bye-bye.